Good evening, welcome to Unity with Heaven. My name is Joseph, and today we have Julian and Elisma and Amy and Kimmy ministering with us. So it's we mixing it up every single week, so that's wonderful. We missed you all on Friday night. We were not here, but I did send you a little video. 15 people put their names on Friday, and I think we ministered to most of them already. So, but tonight we're going to minister to 50 people, and all the names that's more than 50, I'll put it on the list, and we'll make sure that we'll minister to those. Also, we are also recording, so tomorrow morning I'll take the recording and I'll also post it on the channel. So if for some reason the sound wasn't perfect, we have a backup. All right, so a prophetic protocol from 1 Corinthians chapter 14 verse 3, it says there, when you prophesy, the word must edify, exhort and comfort. And so tonight when we minister to you, we will make sure that the word edify, exhort and comfort. Okay, we'll also say a special welcome to Shannon, that's doing the camera work, and Lindy is Gilliam's wife, and she is pregnant, and it's very, very hot here in South Africa, so I told her it's perfect time that she chose to be pregnant. But I think that's 31st of March. Okay, so she'll make it. All right, so I think we're going to start ministering right now. The first person I want to minister to is Vicky Verity. All right, Vicky, the Lord's hand is upon you, and the Lord is setting up opportunities for you in January. And I felt in December, the Lord wants you to rest, and He doesn't want you to worry about the next year. Trust in the Lord. He is setting intersections, people, and connections, and resources supply for you. So you do not have to worry. Just trust in God and rest and walk with Him, and you'll see how you'll open up the doors of blessing. God bless you.
Awesome. My word is for Naomi. Naomi, the word that I have for you is, I don't know if you know this, but a lot of early scientists were actually Christians, and the things that led them to become scientists were actually the fact, their worldview when it came to God. Their perspective of God led them to believe that because God is good and because He's ordered and because He's ordered the universe, it actually led them to look for laws and to look for things in nature to correspond. And that's how a lot of scientific discoveries were made. So the thing that I feel for you is just, I see how you've got a certain perspective about God, and there's certain things that God's been highlighting to you over these last couple of years, just in your relationship with Him. And I feel like God is going to use that to open up doors. It's almost like scientific discoveries, things that have been there all along. And I just feel like God wants you to encourage you that the truth in the Bible and the truth that He's been teaching you and what He's been showing you has a real world consequence and a real world outflow. Cool.
Amen. Next word is for Amanda. I see you standing with lights in your hand, and you're directing the traffic. And it sometimes is getting stressful, and sometimes the lights are going dim, and then they can't see you, and then there's chaos, and then you almost like shake it, and then it's bright again, and then you're happy again. It's almost like God says that you need to keep your lamp full. You need to keep it filled with the Holy Spirit. You need to keep it filled with the Word of God. You need to, you know, stay in prayer, stay in that state of worshiping the Lord, and stay in that state of trusting the Father, so that you can direct people into the right way. Because it's almost like you are the director of your family. You help them to get to the Lord. You help them to get saved. So don't stop doing that. Sometimes it will get discouraging. Sometimes it will get overwhelmed. But God says, keep on doing that, because you're doing a great job. Be blessed.
Amen. God bless you, Amanda. God loves you so much. Please leave a comment down below. We'd love to connect with you. Everyone else, we love you. God bless you. And yeah, let's keep on commenting and praying for the people receiving ministry. This next word is for Joel. Joel from Prophetic Prophet Joel Ministries. Joel, God loves you so much. And the picture God showed me for you, was God was like calling you into like higher places. So just like Moses, when God called Moses to go up that mountain, and Moses saw the face of God. And because he saw the face of God, it's like his face shone with the glory of God. And I saw a picture of how you're like every single day spending time with God in a special place. And every day when you look in the mirror, it's like you like look more and more like God, and you just get His image, and you receive His character. Because it's so true, the people that we spend time with the most, we become like these people. And I just see how the Lord is really strengthening your relationship with Him. And then I saw a picture of how you give people mirrors. It was a very interesting picture, and I saw people like looked at themselves in the mirror, and then you like encouraged them. We are made in the image of God, and we're called to look like God. And I just see that your whole ministry, especially for 2025, is to bring people into the presence of God and to teach them to have a relationship with God. And I just feel God is just giving you the research, the resources and the wisdom that you need for it. God loves you so much, and I really want to encourage you. God's hand is upon you. God loves you. God bless you.
Amen, Joel, blah, blah, blah. Please write us a comment. I was about to say blah, blessed, but please write us a comment. Thanks for this for Mariette. The Lord shows me how he is taking you through a period of just release. I see how you are shedding this old skin, and this old skin is like your this old self-image of yourself, this old plan that you've had for yourself, how you just shed that before the Lord and you release it. You release your own idea of how it needs to be and how it needs to look. You say, Lord, it doesn't need to look how I see it or how I think it should be. It needs to be how you want it. I see how the Lord is saying for you to receive his heart again and receive the mind of Christ to put into practice what he wants what he wants you to do and what he wants you to release. Be blessed.
Hey, awesome. Mariette, God bless you. So, family, I see these two or three people that put lots of names, but it's the same handle. Okay? So, I don't like that. Just for a simple reason, I'm not sure if the person whose name you put on has given us permission for us to minister to you. So if, you know, your name handle is Joseph and you write there Joseph, then I have a lot of confidence to put your name on, because I know you've asked the person, and it's fine. This is a live stream and my name is on there. I wrote it myself. So, but if it's someone else's name that you put on, I'll put it on the list of the extra names, and we'll later minister to the person. But I don't want to minister to the person at the live stream, because I don't think, from my own protocol, that's the right thing to do. So I just want to let you guys know, there's a two or three of you that puts lots of names. I'm not going to put them on the list. Just letting you know. Okay, but I still love each one of you very, very much. Okay, so now I want to minister to Nadine. Nadine, the Lord shows me a start button. It's a green button. On the button is written start. I see how the Lord presses this. And I felt the Lord is speaking to you about your ministry is starting, leading people is starting, being an example is starting, taking financial responsibility is starting. And so you went through a time of restoration that the Lord has taken you through. But I felt that the Lord says, now it's going to be healing by participation. So it means you're going to work, you're going to do the work of God. And through that process of God flowing through you, he will heal you and restore you and make you and grow your maturity so that you can be whole before the Lord. God bless you.
Awesome. My word is for Gail. I'm so sorry for mispronouncing your name. The word of the thing that I got for you is I saw this orchard, this bunch of like trees, almost like a forest. And I just saw how it was like your life's work to like grow all these trees. And then it felt like everything was just cut down in like a few minutes. And it felt like the end. But the thing that I saw is how all of that, all of those trees ended up becoming like construction wood. That you were able to build this huge building that was able to like house many people. And the thing that I feel like God's saying is, I feel like you just came from a season where, you know, you'd given your life to something. I mean, really like invested in people, and you were like looking forward to the fruit. And then all of a sudden it feels like everything was just chopped down. And I feel like God just wants to remind you and encourage you that this isn't the end. This is a new season. And the way that he's going to bring the breakthrough is going to look a lot different than you expected. But it's going to open up so many doors for so many other people. Be blessed.
I mean, next word is for Fishal. I feel that it's almost like there's a mask over your face. And you really want to voice. God has given you a voice. And he wants you to speak in front of people. He wants you to minister in front of people. But people have put a mask over your face. It's like almost like they're trying to mute you. They're trying to change you into what you are not. So God says it's time to take off that mask. It's time to take off what people says over you and about you.
Yeah.
And it's time to just be who you are. And God has definitely made made you to be a voice. He's made you to speak in front of people. He has made you because there's a lot of authority in your voice. So stand up into what God has called you to be, and let's just rip off everything the world has placed on you. Be blessed.
Amen. God loves you. God bless you. This next word is for Lelia. Lelia, you're such a blessing. It's so good to see you. Lelia, I just really feel how the Lord is right now stretching you in this season, how the Lord wants you to grow and expand so you can receive more of His love. And I just feel like you have such a desire for His heart. And then the picture God showed me for you was how I saw this beautiful garden, and it was stunning, but there were some plants there, you know, you get certain plants that take up all the water, and then it makes all the other plants not have enough water. And I just saw how the Lord says it's time to cut off the things that is taking away. And I just feel the Lord says that I want to renew you. I want to take away the unnecessary, and I want to plant new seeds in those patches. And I just see how you spend time with God, and how He helps you take out the weeds, and how He helps you fill up those places with the Holy Spirit. Lately, God loves you so much, and I really feel God is preparing you for such a time as this. God is filling you up with His confidence, His glory, but also giving you a heart of not only worship, but excellence. You know, the scripture that says that worship the Lord in excellence, and I feel in your works that you do, that's what it's going to be. It's going to be a fragrance of worship, and it's just going to be so wonderful for God. God loves you. God bless you.
Amen. Layla, please give us common sense for this for Wayne. Wayne, the Lord shows me how you feel like things are just going good and then it goes bad again. And then the Lord shows me how you feel you can't find a consistent line where everything's just going right. And I hear the Lord saying that even in the highs and even in the lows, the Lord is reminding you to come to Him, to come and sit at His feet. Do not neglect the time. Do not just come to the Lord when you are in mourning, but come to the Lord when you are rejoicing as well. I hear the Lord saying that I want to be a part. The Lord says I want to be a part of every emotion, every aspect of your life, the highs and the lows. I want to be there. The Lord is saying, invite me into those times. Be blessed.
Hey, Wayne, God bless you. The Lord is... I see a tuning forth in the Lord. The Lord is just tuning you. The Lord loves you very, very much. All right. So family, we are ministering to 50 people tonight. All the names, that's more than 50, are putting it on a separate list. And I will make sure that we also minister to those people. So, I think there's about 40 names already on. So there's about spots for 10 more names. All right. So the next person is Jock. Jock, the Lord shows me how the blessing of God, the favor of God, is just following you wherever you go. And you know, in Psalm chapter 23, the Lord is talking about how the blessing of God and the mercy, the grace of God is following him. And the Lord is just showing me the fire of God, His anointing, opportunities, intersections that He gives to you with right people. And I feel you haven't met everyone that God wants you to meet. He's going to give you intersections. You're going to meet people. He's setting it up for you. And so you better be ready to say, I'm happy to meet new people that God puts in my network. God bless you, Jock.
Awesome. My word is for Ivan. The word of the thing that I have for you is I saw this this wall of light bulbs. And I saw you like individually change like every single one of them, like got on a ladder. And then right as you like put in the last light bulb at the bottom, it was like one of the ones at the top that just went off. And it was almost this moment of, I just went through all this effort. And the thing that I kind of saw is I saw how like you got kind of like a new gadget or a new thing so that you're able to change it quicker. And it almost made you feel like, oh, it's this, like it was almost this, not frustration, but just this feeling of, if I had known it was this easy, I wouldn't have gone through all that effort. And the thing that I feel like God's saying through all this is, I feel like you went through this whole process of being faithful, and it feels like you just finished it, and it doesn't seem like it's gonna last. And I feel like God's showing you a new way, and He's gonna show you a new way to do things, and it's gonna feel like, you know, if I'd known about this new way, I wouldn't have done the old way. And I feel like God really just wants you to know two things. One is that those years or the time that you put in wasn't a waste. And then number two, just because there's a new way to do something, and just because there's a new thing that the Lord's teaching you how to do, it doesn't void the previous years. Those are good developmental years, and the Lord sees your faithfulness. Be blessed.
I mean, next year is for Joanna. Joanna, I see you are in a fish skeleton, and it's almost like you feel it's empty there and there's nothing there. And then I see as you reach your hands up, it's almost like you are pulling things down from heaven, and there's so many colors, and the people, God puts people in there with you, and it starts feeling like home. So it's almost like God is going to send new people over your path, and sometimes where you are at the moment, it doesn't feel like home. It doesn't feel like everything is working at the moment, but God is going to send people. He's going to send you resources, and He's going to send that fullness that only He can give to you, so that you can move in this place. And then I see how this skeleton, it's almost like it gets a flesh around it, and how it gets alive. So God is going to bring breakthrough in your life with newness in your life. Be blessed.
Amen, Johanna. God loves you so much. That's such a beautiful word. God loves you. God bless you. This next word is for Reinhardt. Reinhardt, God loves you so much. And I saw a picture of Samson while praying for you, and I just saw how God was strengthening you. And Samson's calling, he was set apart even from the very beginning, and he had a covenant of God. He couldn't like cut his hair, or I don't think he could have. He couldn't eat anything intoxicating, and it was just a covenant that he made with God. And I just see how you come into the presence of God, and how the Lord is just making a covenant with you and your family, and how the Lord has called you to be like a protector, because that was Samson's calling, to be a protector of the children of God. And I just feel how the Lord is just clothing you with his armor, how the Lord has called you to be a father figure, a protector, a father to a lot of people. And I just feel how the Lord says, I'm filling you up with my Holy Spirit, that rivers of living water shall flow through you, and that will be the word of God and his life. And I just see how you're prophesying and speaking life over so many young people, prophesying and speaking God's word over them and their calling, because there's so many people in this world that don't have identity. And I just see how God has given you the calling just to really be a blessing and to bless people, especially, I don't know if it's youth or it's your own kids, but I just feel there's a lot of prophetic words that God has placed in your heart. God loves you, is giving you strength. God bless you.
Amen. Reina, please leave us a comment. This next word is for your son. The Lord shows me how this is a time for you. This is a time of worship and of praise and of almost like battle. The Lord shows me how this thing that you are up against, this calls for worship and for loud praise, to release. The Lord says, I want you to release a sound of might. And the Lord shows me, he has placed that inside of you. He has given you the tools. The Lord shows me how he's going to surround you with people in this season that the Lord has also spoken to, that this is a time to release a sound of might. And almost like when they were walking, when the Israelites were walking around Jericho and they gave that loud shout, the Lord is saying that I want you to release a shout. Be blessed.
Hey, Darshan, God bless you. All right, Sam, the Lord showed me how you ran and then you fell. And so you lost a little bit of skin and a little bit of your pride, maybe. And then the Lord helps you to stand up and to heal. And I just felt that the Lord is just saying, do not fear. Do not allow your thought and your expectation and your faith in God fail. Sometimes we fall and things happen. But the Lord is going to bring restoration to you, and he's going to help you, he's going to mature you, and you're going to grow through this process. God bless you, Sam.
So, Mel, the word that I got for you is, I just saw, I just felt like God is saying that he's breaking the cycle. And I feel like a lot of times we've got patterns in our lives, and we've got things that we feel like, I don't really see the way out of this. And to the point where I sometimes feel like, God, do you want me to live like this? And the thing that I just feel like God's saying is that he's breaking the cycle, and he's showing you, it's almost like if you're on a highway or on a roundabout, and there are certain exits and certain things that you feel like, you know, I keep missing the exit, I don't know where to get off. And I feel like God is going to show you, and he's going to indicate to you where the exit points are. Be blessed.
I mean, next word is for Siddhi. I feel that you are moving. It's almost like you are moving in this ball, and it is clay, and it's red clay. And as you are moving in this ball, there's more colors coming to this, and it's almost like God says, the more you move into Him, the more you go into Him, the more colors He will give to you. The more it's almost like the more gifts He will give to you. The more power he will give to you. In other words, you know, you will be able to pray longer. You will be able to hear more of his voice. You'll be able to have a better revelation of what God is showing to you. But you need to roll into him. You need to roll into the word. You need to roll into what God has called you to be. And it's almost like he wants you to connect with new people. So just be sensitive to the Holy Spirit's voice. Be blessed.
I mean, God bless you. God loves you. This next word is for Elisma. Elisma, God loves you so much. And I just feel God's hand is upon you. God says he's with you. The picture God showed me for you was how you were sitting on your desk, and right in front of you was a lot of paperwork and a lot of admin that you needed to do. And I just saw how the Lord says, I'm with you. I'm going to help you get through this. And I just see how God is really forming like a partnership with you, and how he helps you work through all this stuff that you need to work on. And then Elisma, I just feel how God is completely healing you in every single area of your life. How the Lord is just saying to you that I am restoring and taking back what the enemy has stolen from the past, especially time. And I just feel the Lord is just bringing a lot of restoration for that. Then lastly, I just feel there's such a beautiful breakthrough that God is doing in your household. God is bringing, it's like a wave of peace and joy into your house, where just the presence of God is really going to be there. And I don't know if he loved you like invite people for coffee or to cater, but I just feel the Lord says that there's just such an anointing in your life to really just be a loving person, and just to show the love of Jesus, because I just feel that that superpower is going to help a lot of people come closer to God and to get saved. God loves you so much. God bless you.
Amen. Elisma, please leave us a comment. This next word is for Akash, I'm not sure, but the Lord shows me for you, I hear the word saying don't roll over, don't give up, don't compromise on the word that the Lord has given you to fulfill, just because maybe others are saying no, you don't have to be that strict, you can do a little bit of that, that is actually fine, it's not going to affect you that much. The Lord is saying do not compromise, stick to what I have told you to do, what I have assigned you to do. And the Lord shows me he has made it very, very clear to you. And don't let others come in and say you don't need to be this strict with what you're doing. And the Lord's saying, no, this is what I am creating with you. This is supposed to be holy. This is supposed to be me. This is supposed to have like the Lord's hand. His name is going to be on this. Do not compromise. And I hear the Lord saying, do not be angry with those people. Bless them, but also know that your business is with you and the Lord. Be blessed.
Akash, God bless you. Family, if any one of you would like to receive prayer, write your name in a comment and say, I would like to have prayer, and just say what you want prayer for. And then I want to ask each one that are joining us tonight, if you see someone put a prayer request in the comments, please pray for them. And just give them a one-line feedback on your prayer that you gave to the Lord for them. That will really help each other when we bless each other with prayer. So I want to minister to Frankie. Frankie, the Lord gives me the word maintenance and restoration. That's the two things. Or let me rather say it like this. Maintenance and upgrade. Those two words. All right? And I felt that the Lord says, son, I'm going to give you the provision and the resources that you need so that you can do the maintenance and the upgrade that you need to do. God bless you.
Awesome. My word is for Joshua. The thing that I saw was how you were standing in front of this. It was this curtain thing, and you're waiting for, let's say you're a performer. You're waiting for the show to start. And it's almost this moment of, you don't know who's standing on the other side of the curtain. You don't know who the audience is. And a lot of times, I don't know if you've ever done any sort of stage performance or presentation or anything, but sometimes it can be really nerve-wracking to stand there and to wonder, okay, cool, am I going to see anyone I recognize? Did my family come? Did my friends come? And I just see how the curtain opens up, and it's literally just God sitting there and he's smiling. And I feel like there are things that you're stressing about, and you're like, I have this performance thing I have to perform, and I feel like God just wants to remind you that you're performing for an audience of one. It's literally just him, and he's already so pleased with you. So, yeah, be blessed.
Amen. My next one is from Marika. Marika, I see you sitting and there's a person standing in front of you, and it's almost like he's got something in his hands that he was beating you with. So I don't know if you went through abuse. It can either be verbal abuse, physical abuse, but I can sense a feeling of fear and anxiety. So God says you need to just give everything to him, go speak to someone, and so that can get released, so that you can get rid of that anxiety, and God says forgiveness is also a big thing, so that you can, you know, so that you can be set free, so that you can be released, and so that you can move forward, and so that you can help other people that went through that. Maybe you can comment or send us a private message, so that we can also pray with you for that. Be blessed, Marika.
Amen. God bless you, Marika. God loves you so much. You're such a blessing. This next word is for Francois. Francois, God loves you so much. And I saw a picture of how...
Francois. Yes.
Thank you. Francois, God loves you very much. And the picture God showed me for you was how you were working outside in the garden. God told you to go work, so you went and you did your best. But then after the end of the day, your feet were so dirty with mud after a long, hard day of work and doing God's work. And then you come back and you're so tired. And I just see how God is saying to you, I want you to allow me to wash your feet, just like Jesus washed the disciples' feet. And I just see how you sit down and you receive and you allow Jesus to wash your feet and tell you that he loves you. And I just feel the Lord says, I'm taking you into a receiving time of your life. When you are giving, you've been faithful, but the Lord says right now you need to rest and you need to receive the gifts that I have for you. If I could describe it, it's like you're working and there's like this prison right next to you, but you keep on working and working because as you can open up the prison, like, no, I gotta keep on working. And I just feel the Lord says it's a gift and I want you to receive it. God loves you so much, and I really feel God has really given you an anointing to be a giver, and God is going to make a way. He's opening up doors for finances, resources, giving you the plans and knowledge and strategy. But he's also, I just feel God just wants to give you a gift, so just receive all those gifts that he wants to give you. God loves you. God bless you.
Amen. This next is for Milandri. The Lord shows me how you are carrying this very, very heavy load. And I hear the Lord saying that there will always be pressure. There will always be something to carry. But it's you can decide whether you're going to carry that by yourself or you're going to come to the Lord saying, I need you. I just hear those words need to be on your lips. Lord, I need you. Lord, I can't do this without you. Lord, I want you to help me. Lord, if I'm not supposed to carry this, help me carry what I'm supposed to. The Lord shows me that there needs to be a yoking. You need to be yoked with the Lord. You need to just connect with him and carry what he wants you to carry. And I see whatever the Lord wants you to carry is going to be something that you are going to multiply into amazing things. And I see that's what the Lord is really calling you. I see how you are amazing at multiplying, at bringing things that were just one, and then you made it more, or you invested, or you planted, and then not only there grew one seed, but there grew many, many plants. So the Lord's saying, release what you are carrying, or carry what I want you to carry, but carry it with me, if that makes sense. Be blessed.
Hey, Milandri, God bless you. So I saw in a comment you wrote there that you're 14 years old. So the majority of people in the world that get saved at the age of 14. That's the most people worldwide, if I understand it correctly, get saved at the age of 14. So in other words, on average, there's going to be more people in your age category that get saved right now than other people. And so be on fire. Encourage your friends. Be open to testify and to witness to them. Yeah. You know, the disciples of Jesus were young people. They were full of fire. They were used by God in a very powerful way. And so the Lord can use you too. Don't think, okay, I'm too young. You are 100% old enough to prophesy, to fill people with the Holy Spirit, to preach the gospel, to see people get saved, to do everything an old person do. You got more energy. So use this opportunity. All right, God bless you, Milandri. Christine, the Lord shows me a line of intercessors and how they walk together. And it's as if the leader is saying, hold the line, everybody, just walk together, stay in step, stay in unity with one another. pray together, support each other, and just stay together. And I felt that the Lord says, although you feel you are fast and you can go faster, don't go ahead. Stay with the rest and keep the unity, because you are carrying a lot of people with you if you stay in unity. God bless you.
Awesome. Sienna, the word that I got for you is I saw, I don't know if you know this, but like old cameras, when they first made cameras, they would call them pinhole boxes. And you can actually make your own cameras today even. And it's literally just by poking a hole in the box, and then there's a few other things you do that I can't remember now how you do it. But bottom line, literally the technology to take pictures existed for thousands and thousands and thousands of years. People just didn't know how to use it. And I feel like you're sitting in front of problems and you're sitting in front of things and you're almost frustrated because you don't know how you're going to solve them. And I feel like God's going to show you a solution, and it's going to feel too obvious, too simple. And I feel like he just wants to encourage you to trust him in that moment when he shows you the solution. Because he's created resources and he's created solutions. And he's literally designed the planet. He knows how everything works in detail. So I just want to encourage you to trust him with whatever solution or thing that he suggests to the problem or thing that you're facing. Be blessed.
Amen. Next word is for Christina. Christina, I see you walking on the beach and you're picking up shells. And as you pick them up, you see them. This is what they look like. This is the color. This is the shape. But when you put it in your hands, it's almost like it changes shape. It changes color. It changes everything. So it's almost like God is saying he's going to change things in your life. You might think it looks like that. You might think that is what's going to happen. But God says he's going to change things. All you need to do is trust him, rest in him, and he will do miracles in your life. And I feel that there's also a healing. You pray for healing in your family or for yourself or someone very close to you, and God is going to bring a miracle in that. You keep on trusting, you keep on having faith, and you keep on praying for yourself or for that person. In Jesus' name, and it will be done. Be blessed.
Amen. God bless you, Christina. God loves you. This next word is for Ari. Ari, God loves you so much, and I just feel the Lord says now is the time, and I just feel the Lord says just keep on walking with me. I'm holding your hand, and I just feel how there's a lot of things that you're saying against yourself. You're like, okay, let's try it again, but I just feel the Lord says do it and keep on going, and the more you go, the better things are going to get. And I just feel the Lord is just saying to you, don't give up, keep on walking with me, I'm with you. And then I saw a picture of how God is really saying to you, you know, you can't really wear like one outfit for the whole year because it's going to be winter, it's going to be summer. You got to change for every single season. And I just saw how you go into room to room, and it's like you change your clothes completely, and you and like one day you're wearing purple, another day you're wearing red, one day you're dressing a bit warmer, one day you're dressing for a cooler season. And I just see how the Lord says, I'm going to give you the wisdom, but also the flexibility, and I'm going to be with you in every single area of your life. And I just feel God is giving you so much wisdom of how to interact with different people, and that's going to open up a lot of doors, a lot of friendship in your life. And you know, there's this word in scripture that says that when the moment comes, God will give you the right words to say. And I just feel the Lord says when those moments come, he's going to give you those right words to say. God loves you so much. God bless you.
Hey, Miss Aria, please leave us a comment, even though you've already left us like 10 comments. Mm-hmm. We are very, very grateful. Thank you so much. This next word is for Rochelle. The Lord shows me you baking, and or Rochelle, I'm not sure, Rochelle, Rochelle. The Lord shows me you baking, and I hear the Lord saying that even like in like the process, you might have to do the same thing over and over again until you get it like perfect. But I hear the Lord saying, choose joy, do it with joy. Even if this is something that there is a recipe for it, but sometimes it doesn't go exactly as to plan. The Lord is saying, go with joy and know that eventually, if you keep trying, if you stay persistent, and if you like not go slowly, but take your time to read the recipe or go through the plan and make sure that every step is, you know, is just as good as you can get it, and you have joy. The Lord shows me how not only will you probably get to the process quicker because you will be less frustrated, but you will also be able to have more fun and grow and learn something, and not take it as criticism, but take it as something that you can grow from. So I just hear the Lord saying, choose joy. Be blessed.
Hey, Rochelle, God bless you. Family, I think at number 46 on listing the names. So I'm gonna list people's names until 50, and then all the names that's extra, I'll just put it on a separate list. Okay, so Tony the Lord shows me that how he made the earth in 6 days, and one day he rested, and he actually said you must work 6 days and rest one day. And then Jesus said, is there not 12 hours in a day that you can work? Work while it's time, because when it's night you cannot work. And then I saw you the whole time with your phone and your laptop, and you're just busy. Every time when you need to write an email, or when someone messages you, you feel obligated, you must do it right there and then. And I felt that the Lord says, there's a time slot that is given to you where you're going to sit by your computer and you're going to do your stuff. And then there's other times that's for God, that's for your family, it's for your health, exercise, things like that. And the Lord wants you just to bring a little bit of a separation between those times, so that you are not always working, but you have to have times where you rest and times where you're working. And I see how the Lord separates that, and then there's a lot more blessing that come into your life when you honor yourself in that way. God bless you.
Lydia, I have a word for you. It's kind of a funny one, at least in my mind. there's this quote from Sun Tzu's Art of War where he says, never interrupt your enemy while they're making a mistake. And there's a scripture where it says, don't repay evil for evil, but repay evil for good. And the thing that I just feel like I just want to remind you of is, sometimes there's so much evil, and there's so many things that you see, and so much unfairness in the world around us, that we feel like, you know what, I'm justified to react or to retaliate. And I just want to encourage you not to interrupt the enemy while the enemy is making a mistake. The enemy is heaping upon his judgment upon himself. But for you, don't repay evil with evil, repay evil with good. And I just want to encourage you with that. Be blessed.
I mean, next word is for Jobin. Jobin, I see the scripture, so me and my house, we will serve the Lord. And I see there's someone close to you that you are trying to win back to God, but you are struggling and you don't know what to do, and it's almost like you want to give up. But God says, do not give up. Keep on praying. Keep on being that example. Keep on being that the fruit, so that he can see, or she can see, the love of Jesus inside of you. And then it's almost like you can speak that scripture instead of as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. You speak, as for me and my people, we will serve the Lord. So keep on speaking that speak, because that word is alive, because every word in the Bible is alive and active, and it really works. I can testify that about that in my life, and therefore if he can do it for me, he can do it for you. Be blessed.
Amen. Yes, God loves you so much. God bless you, Jovan. This next word is for Angela. Angela, God loves you so much, and I feel the Lord says it's time to come into the promised land. So I saw a picture of how, you know, some types of work in life, we get into a routine and every single day feels the same, and I just feel like, Lord, I want to get out of this loop. And I just feel the Lord says the promised land is right there. You don't have to be like those Israelites that went around 40 years. They could have just went and they didn't. And I just feel the Lord says that now is the time to step into that place with me. And then Angela, I just feel God is reminding you how much he loves you, how precious you are to him. And I just feel God is saying to you, I have vision for your life. I'm inviting you to spend time with me and let me speak my vision over you. I see how you spend time with God and you got a piece of paper and a pen. You're like, okay, God, talk to me. What am I supposed to do for 2025? And I just feel like God fills up your heart instead of fear with joy and excitement and vision. While praying for you, I feel like, I don't know if you're gonna get like a business partner or just a partner in general with I don't know if it's ministry or work, but I just feel God is going to send some amazing people to your life. God loves you. God bless you.
Amen. Angela, please hear us to come on this next word for Simon. Simon, The Lord's saying, you know, how January is coming, and usually in January people are like, I have this whole new plan and it's gonna go great. I really hear the Lord saying, but this he wants you to apply in the coming year, but in every day he's saying, don't wait until you feel your best, or until the situation is just right, or you woke up at the right time. And the Lord's saying, don't wait, and don't wait just because you missed the scheduled time that you were planning with spending with the Lord. Don't think, well, that time is gone now, I need to get back to my schedule. I hear the Lord saying, reminding him that the appointments that you make with him are there's no time. The Lord is outside of time. So whenever
the Lord to spend time with me. Don't wait on that time. Don't think tomorrow, because I really see in your life that whatever time, and it doesn't need to be a set time, but every day there needs to be an appointment with you and the Lord, because He wants to love on you, and He wants to encourage you, and He wants to counsel you, and He wants to correct you, because His correction is good. And that is what He wants to give to you, but He can't give that if you don't make yourself available to Him. Be blessed.
Hey, awesome. Give me faithful, available, and teachable. That doesn't spell fat, it just
it spells fart.
Yeah. Ingrid, the Lord shows me a fueling station, like a petrol station, and how cars come there and you just fill each one with fuel, with petrol and diesel and whatever they need. And what the Lord is saying to me, that He has made you to be an encourager, and He's filling you, you are filling people up with the love of God, with the anointing of God, with love, with encouragement, just with hope for their future. And so the Lord is using you in a mighty way in that way. God bless you, Ingrid.
Dricky, the word I have for you is, I saw this balloon that's inflating, and it looks like... it's like a water balloon kind of thing. It's inflating, but the more that it inflates, the more there's this tension, and you almost have this feeling of, it's gonna burst now, it's gonna burst now, it's gonna burst now. And the thing that I feel like God's saying is, I just saw that, and then I saw this thing about long suffering, and this whole idea that God is so patient. And I think there are so many times where you feel like, I've really tested God's patience, I'm testing His patience, and I feel like God's saying it's a lot stronger than you think it is. And I just feel like God just wants to remind you that He's not waiting to blow up. There's a lot more grace, and there's a lot more love than you can even imagine. So yeah, be blessed.
Amen. Next week is for Dawn. Dawn, I feel like God is coming to you, and He touches your hands, and it's almost like He's giving you a fresh anointing of healing, and He wants you to pray for more people. He wants you to speak life into people's lives, and He wants you to pray healing over people's lives. And even if you don't see an instant healing, just know that God can work through those people, and then healing will come, and maybe at a later stage, because sometimes we pray for people and then they don't get healed instantly, and we think like, but why not? But God does a work in each and everyone, and He will finish a work that He started. So keep on doing what you are doing, and I see how you are just, you are coming from a place where you are refreshed, and it's almost like you are ready to go, where lots of people, there's some of the year they're tired and they don't want to go, but you are ready to go, because you know where to get your strength from, you know where to go get your strength from, and keep on going so that you can lift up other people, and so that you can encourage the people that is low at the moment. Be blessed.
Amen. God bless you. God loves you, Dawn. You are such a blessing. And I just feel God is just restoring so much joy to you. You are called to be a carrier of the joy of God. So laugh. God loves you when you laugh. All right, this next word, and happy. All right, so this next word is for Johnson. Johnson, God loves you so much, and I just feel God is giving you courage to learn a new skill. I saw a picture of how you were watching your kids, or like maybe a younger... I just saw how they were like jumping rope. You saw a bunch of kids jumping rope, and you're like, I could do that. And then you started joining in, and then you like trip, and it's like, oh my goodness, this is so messy. And then I see how you just, but you're still so brave to keep on going. And I just saw how you learn, and then all of a sudden you're like skipping like a pro. And I just feel the Lord says that be brave to try new things, and I want you to do it with joy. And I just feel the new things that you're going to receive is going to be not only a blessing for your life, but for a lot of people's lives. I just feel the Lord says, look at the, I'm giving you, like, you know how this is the saying, look at the world through rose-colored glasses. I just saw how you're going to look through the world through Jesus' eyes, but also through eyes with courage and joy, and how you're going to learn new skills, especially for 2025, and how that's going to be such a blessing to you and be such a joy for you in your life. God loves you. He is with you. God bless you.
Amen, Johnson. Please leave us a comment. Next word is for Edgar. The Lord shows me, He says, do not hold back. Release, release, release.
the Lord shows me how maybe some people will get uncomfortable, or they will be like, this is something new and we're not too sure about this. But I really hear the Lord saying, just release, because sometimes we need to get uncomfortable, and we need to grow, and we need to experience, not just experience the Lord, but we need to truly know Him. And the Lord shows me how you know the Lord, and you are inviting like maybe a small group of people just into that deep relationship that you have with the Lord, and you are helping them to grow in their own relationships with the Lord. And the Lord is not a respecter of persons. He wants to have just as strong a relationship with you as the next person. But if you are available and you say, Lord, I'm going to be the one that will help release your plan, and the Lord says that He will use you. So don't be afraid to release this revelation that the Lord is giving to you. Be blessed.
Yeah, Igor, God bless you. The family, there was a request in the comments just to give the times. So it's 6:00 South African time on a Monday and 7:30 on a Friday when we have our live streams. Okay, so maybe you can just work it out where you are in the world, but in South African time, 6:00 on a Monday and 7:30 in here. Yeah, 7:30 on a Friday. Okay, so, and I also wrote it there in the comments. I tried to work out in my head when is it the central time there in the US, and I tried to write it, and you guys can double check me to see if I got it right. I'm 65% sure that I'm accurate. Okay. Okay, so the next word is for Natalia. Okay, Natalia, the Lord shows me two things: provision for your family and revival spiritually for the church. I feel that the Lord is putting you in the church. He's growing, He's bringing revival, He's bringing an outpouring of the Holy Spirit. And I see you personally are very involved as someone that cares, encourages, and also do evangelistic work. That means bring new people into the church, and also sponsoring people that just gave their lives to God. You're a very caring person, and the Lord is giving you resources. God bless you.
Awesome. Sibongile, the word that I got for you is I saw the shopping cart. I don't know if you ever pushed a shopping cart and then one of the wheels is just like spinning like crazy, like all the other wheels are working fine and there's one wheel that's spinning. And the thing that I feel like is, I feel like you're on this vehicle, and you're on this journey, and it feels like one of the wheels is just going crazy, like one of those shopping cart wheels, and there's this fear that it's going to be derailed all because of this one wheel. I don't know if you're working on like a team project and it feels like there's this one person that's spinning uncontrollably, there's this one loose factor, this one thing that's just too much. And the thing that I feel like God is saying is that one spinning thing, just like with a shopping cart, it's not going to derail the cart. It's not going to derail what He's doing in your life. There are enough things that are solid, that are sturdy, that are secure, that those factors and those things that are spinning uncontrollably is not going to derail His plan for your life. Be blessed.
Amen. Next word is for Peter. Peter, I feel that God is saying that He is going to protect you, even though around you it seems like things are just chaos and things are, it's like unresolvable. God says that He is going to resolve it. He's going to give you a way, but He's going to protect you through all of this. I feel that He's placing almost like a shield over you with no weapon formed against you shall prosper. And I feel that your family goes underneath that shield also. And while you pray for them, the shield gets bigger and bigger and bigger. So just stand in that place of God will protect you because He is your protector, and be aware of what the enemy is trying to do, but don't, you know, just focus on God, because God is big and He is bigger than the one in the world. Be blessed.
Amen. Yes, God loves you. God bless you. This next word is for Caroline. Caroline, God loves you so much, and I just feel God is just giving you so much peace in this time. He's saying to you, peace, be still. And I just feel God is really giving you wisdom, and it's kind of like this whole year or like recently, it's kind of been like walking through like a field and you don't know where's quicksand or where's the solid ground to walk on. And I just feel the Lord says that the path is narrow, but I'm guiding you, I'm your leader. And I just see how you have like the trust in God. And I just feel how God is just comforting you and giving you peace and saying to you, I know what I'm doing. And then lastly, I just really feel God is really healing you in this time. He's just doing such an amazing healing, but he's not only going to heal you, but I just feel that you're going to overflow with that. You're going to pray for people for healing. You're going to share testimonies, and that's going to spark faith in their lives for them to receive, wow, if God can do something this amazing, he can do that in my life. Yeah, I really feel God has called you to pray for people to receive healing. God loves you. God bless you.
Amen. Caroline, please leave us a comment. This next word is for Winnie. The Lord shows me these two trees. I remember now. The Lord shows me these two trees, and from afar away they look like the exact same tree. They're very long and they don't have many branches like at the bottom, but at the top there's a lot of branches. But when you come closer to the trees, you can see this one tree is like barely holding on and this other tree is thriving. And the Lord shows me how he says, look down. And the Lord says, look at the swale. This one tree is growing in the sand, and this other tree is growing in the right swale. And the Lord shows me that from far, the trees look like they're doing fine and they're both growing very well. But when you come close, you see that this tree is in the wrong soil and this tree is in the right soil. And the Lord really wants you to be planted in the right soil, in the right community, in a place where you can grow. And I hear the Lord saying he's coming and he's giving, the Lord shows me he's giving you these new eyes for you to see, like these glasses to see, to look at your roots, to say, am I planted in the right soil? Is this sand and I am a palm tree, or is this really thick, nutritious ground and I am like this evergreen? And the Lord is saying that we are all different and people need to be planted in different places that they will truly, truly grow. Yeah. And the Lord says that is what he wants for you. He wants you to be planted in a place where you will truly, truly grow. Be blessed.
Okay, awesome. Vinny, God bless you. All right, so the next word is for Jane. So Jane, the Lord shows me a wedding and how two people come together and they make that covenant to become one. But then afterwards, when it's the wedding, what do you call the party after the wedding? The
after-party.
No, man, it's the ceremony.
Reception.
The reception part of the wedding, okay? So, not the after party, the reception. I see that they don't play nice music, so the people don't feel comfortable to mingle and to become connected socially, right? And I felt that the Lord says, you need to create an environment, especially for your family, where there's music and there's fun and there's food and they can celebrate and they can connect and they can love each other. And I just felt that the Lord says that he's giving you the anointing and the mandate to create that atmosphere of celebration in your house and also around in your community. And as you do it, then lots of people reconcile, forgive, connect, become one again, work together, new alliances are being formed. And I just felt that the Lord says he's going to use you in a mighty way to create that atmosphere for unity and love and reconciliation. God bless you, Jane.
So, Mimansha, the word that I have for you is, I saw how someone sent you this package. You got it in the mail and you open it up and it was this broken, terrible thing. And you were like, I really, really, really don't like this. Like, it was literally like just a pile of trash that someone scooped into this package. And it was this, I don't know, you just felt terrible. But then, because it's a gift, you felt like you needed to like display it somewhere in your house. And the thing that I feel like God's saying is, you don't have to display broken gifts. You don't have to, those things that the enemy might have sent you, or things that you feel like, well, I guess I deserve this. I don't know why I got this thing. You don't have to take it for yourself. You really don't have to take it. You can send it right back where it came from. And one of the amazing things that Jesus did for us on the cross is he was the scapegoat. which means that he took all our sins, he took everything that the enemy tried to put on us, and he just sent it right back to the enemy. So there's no reason for you to keep that on yourself. The Lord's given you so many better things. Be blessed.
I mean, next word is for John. John, I feel that something big is going to get birthed in your life, and God's light is shining over that. So he says this is a good time for it, this is his perfect timing, and it's going to change your life, but in a good way. So if change is coming, don't be afraid and fear it, because we all, you know, sometimes we are afraid of the unknown, but God says this is his plan for you, and it's going to be a good change. So gather your family around and let them enjoy this big change with you, and don't be discouraged, because God is with you. Be blessed.
Amen. God bless you. God loves you. This next word is for Kaylin. Kaylin, God loves you so much, and I just felt how God has really called you to be a builder of the kingdom of God, and how the Lord says start small and then it will multiply. And I just feel how the Lord says that don't be afraid to, I just saw a picture of you trying different projects, but it's like you were trying like 10, 15, and then I just saw God gave you wisdom, which were the actual projects you're going to do, and I felt it was like 3 or 4, maybe 5, it wasn't like too many, but it was a handful, and I just felt how God really gave you wisdom and vision for each of these projects, and different people, and I feel the Lord is really calling you to be mentored, and also to mentor a lot of younger people as well, and I just feel this is really a time of building amazing things, but in ministry, maybe also in business, but also specifically in yourself, the person that God is building you to, and your character is growing. I just feel there's a lot of growth coming in this season, and how the Lord is really making you strong. And it's like you know, that strong building that doesn't blow away. It's like it's built on the rock, not on the sand. It's not stable, and I just feel how God is really placing you on stable, solid ground and strengthening you and building you up in the season. God loves you. God bless you.
Amen, Kaylin. Please leave us comments. Thanks for this for Bridget. Bridget, the Lord shows me that you are very wise, and that you are a good steward. The Lord shows me that what he has given to you, that you have made sure that you have planted that you make sure that you have enough, that your family has enough. And the Lord shows me how, because you have made sure that you, your family, and everybody has everything that they need, the Lord shows me how he's going to give you ways to bless people. Lots of different ways, but mainly like two. I see like these two, like you are there in like these two like little portals that you are just giving and giving and giving, and the Lord shows me that the things that you have planted that you're not even worried about now, because you know that those are going to reap a good harvest. The Lord shows me that he is while you are giving, he's by the things that you have planted, and he is just adding more to that. He is doubling that. Even as you are doubling it, he is doubling it and doubling it sevenfold. And I hear the Lord saying that as you give, he is working with what you have sown, and he is multiplying that. And the Lord shows me how that is going to be your life for the next maybe couple of years. There's going to be a giving, but there's going to be an immense overflow that the Lord is going to do for your life, especially spiritually, even more so spiritually, and not physical really at all, but spiritual, that spiritual richness that he is giving to you and to your children, and I see how that's going to be as a generational blessing through your giving. Be blessed.
Hey, Bridget, God bless you. Family, if there's any more names after this, I will put them on the list, and I'll make sure that we minister to them. Also, you can go on any Unity with Heaven video or prophetic ministry video, and you can just write your name in the comments anywhere, and I read all the comments, and then I'll put you on the list if you would like to receive ministry. So that's you don't have to worry and wait for a specific time or a specific video. The door is always open. Okay, so family, while I was sitting here, the Lord was just showing to me how many people are called and trained to do things for God and to have ministries and go in different ways. And I feel where you are listening tonight, that if you feel the Lord has called you, go through the preparation. Let the Lord use you. Let him build you where you are, because he will send you and he will give you more and more responsibility as you are faithful and obedient with what he's given to you. And even for us sitting here tonight, alright, so we are 5 people that ministered, and Lindy is also here, and Shannon. And each one of us, the Lord is just showing me, is going to be one day doing amazing things for God. And we might not do it together, but we are now together. Just like the disciples with Jesus was together in one place, and then he sent them later. So the Lord is training people together. And so appreciate who you have in your life where you are right now. Because it might not always be like that. And the Lord will give you more responsibility as time goes on. Alright, so that's just something I felt. And I also want to say to the team, I appreciate each one of you, and thank you, all of you guys that are different. And I mean, like Gillian that's sitting next to you, he's from Every Nation. And Elisma has many things that she's involved with, and she's also involved with a new ministry. And Amy, she is trying to get her ministry also going. And Kimmy is luckily still here in my house, so I'm very happy about that. Awesome. Family, we love and appreciate you. We will be back Friday evening, 7:30. See you then. Have a wonderful week. God bless.
Thank you for joining Unity with Heaven. Remember to subscribe, like, comment, and join our newsletter. If you want to support us, please click on the PayPal link. May God bless you abundantly. Remember, you are valuable, and we love and appreciate each one of you. If you enjoyed this content and you want to see more, please click here.